另一个我觉得这个峰会在整个编排上非常的用心啊。那当然它现在也非常切合整个中国的人民的一个需求，因为现在整个高净值的客户是越来越多，但是现在大家在思索的就是在国外的经验已经这么丰富了，但是在我们自己国内要怎么样去 match 这个部分，我觉得这个是我们在这个峰会是可以学习到的。OK， 其实从今天早上这样听下来，我觉得当然在各个地区啦，不管是 BVI 啦、开门或什么之类，我想我过去自己也有一些接触，所以今天来，我觉得当然所讲的也跟我们过去所接触的是吻合的。但是更难得的是看到说，已经有一些专业性的机构，已经在国内，不管是在香港或在国内，有很多的地方已经开始有一些专业的人士出现了。比方说会开始追溯到信托的本源、信托的制度，以及开展到后方家族信托、家族办公室，或者是到离岸金融。我想这个是可喜的现象，这是我目前所看到的。
I think this conference has just been a wonderful opportunity to kind of bridge the People's Republic of China and the increasing kind of wave of outbound investment and outbound tourism with regions that have always had an interest in building and deepening those relationships, particularly the Caribbean, and more specifically for ourselves, the Bahamas. I think the Bahamas has been an underappreciated jurisdiction or underknown jurisdiction in the PRC, in the People's Republic of China. And I think Minister Pinder being here and myself as the representative of the Bahamar Project, we're trying to boost the profile of the Bahamas so that Chinese high net worth individuals or tourists or businesses can begin to see it as more of a compelling venue for which to base their activities and kind of deepen cooperation between the two countries. So I think I find the summit a very good venue for that. We're learning more about the increasing sophistication of Chinese ultra high networks, how they're structuring their products, how they're wanting trust structures, how they're kind of beginning to manage their affairs with more rigor. And we're also just having a wonderful opportunity to see some of our friends who are here from the Bahamas, whether it's the government delegation, whether it's law firms that are working. So we're really just kind of all, we're networking, we're chatting, we're getting to know each other, and there are a lot of interesting opportunities to kind of continue the dialogues and further the dialogues based on this face-to-face forum.
收获应该说是这个，可以说吧，这是一个很好的一个，这个国内和国外的这个做财富管理这个同业机构一个最好的一个交流的一个平台之一，就是大家这个应该说也是适应了目前国内市场啊中高净值客户他的投资需求啊他的理财的需求资产管理的需求在深化，就是在提升的这么一个阶段，需要境内和境外的机构一块来合作，这是一个比较好的交流平台。刚才就像我前面说的，要适应现在市场的需要，我们现在可能会逐步来推一些，就我们给投资者的叫金融和非金融服务的这个结合点。我觉得这个我们的资产的传承啊，资产的保护，包括这个尤其是中高净值客户的叫什么呢？叫富财传财的需求，投资移民的需求，然后甚至加上有些这个在叫什么呢，个人的这个权益类的安排上面的一些需求啊，现在已经开始有需求。那么我们可能这次峰会以后，我们会把这个接触的这些客户的合作机构的一些信息啊，我们会加以整理，可能会找这个下面这些相关的一些机构来谈具体的合作方案，然后在我们这个业务平台上推出相关的一些我们叫增值服务吧，或者叫非金融服务。
我觉得有很大的收获，因为第一次参加，而且这个主题方面的话是对我们这个行业还有对我们的客户也是非常有这个热门的一个话题嘛。那么多的一个专家啊，海外的国内的而且也透过不同层次的去研究这个家族信托离岸投资这个问题，我觉得是一个非常好的平台。首先我觉得有很多的专家在这个平台上面，大家可以互相交流很多的很好的一些不同的在家族信托方面的一些消息跟资讯，这个是一个很好的机会。那对我们公司来说还有我个人来说的话，一方面也是这个社交网络的一个建设，然后我们也碰到很多其实潜在的客户，在这个峰会里面他们真的是个人来说对这个家族信托的需求也是有的。那所以从公司的层次，从一个社交的平台的层次，然后从一个 专业的层次上面的话，我都觉得这个峰会是很好的一个安排。那可能唯一一点就是说，因为有很多很好的话题，那么时间上面在每一个话题可能都比较紧张一点。那所以呢，如果有更多一些可能互动的这样的一个安排，啊，或者是比较长一点点的时间给这些专业人士也有一些问答的一些时间的话，那可能的听众方面来说，嘉宾来说也会更好的一个安排。
Certainly the conference today I find to be very successful. There's a lot of participants, like you pointed out, there's a lot of participants from China, which is really the important component for a jurisdiction like the Bahamas to build exposure, to build profile and to demonstrate what we have to offer to the Chinese community here, both the advisors and the clients eventually. So we're very pleased to be the platinum sponsor of the conference this year, to be able to come to China, to relaunch our brand in China, in partnership with a lot of the private sector who's here and sponsors of this as well, along with Bahamar, who's a strategic partner in the Bahamas. So we're very happy, we're very pleased. We think it's a huge success, and we look forward to, you know, more activities. Well, yeah, I think that this is a great stepping stone for the Bahamas. Certainly China Offshore is the preeminent financial services, international financial services conference that is held here in China. And certainly the Bahamas would like to be the platinum sponsor and lead sponsor again in the project next year in the summit. We believe that our model fits what the Chinese client is looking for. And we believe and put our dedication behind the product. So certainly year in and year out, we like to see a summit or a conference grow in numbers. But numbers isn't everything. It's the quality of the participants. It is the advisors, the top level advisors, the lawyers, the managers of assets. Those are the types of persons that we like to be in front of. And those are the types of persons that make the decisions on where their clients are to be and where their assets are going to be. So we're very pleased with the makeup of the attendees here today. We note that there's a lot of asset managers and a lot of lawyers here, which is very good. And so we would like to see that type of demographic of participants grow next year in the conference. I think that you have a good mix of speakers. You have certainly Chinese advisors speaking, but you have those international advisors as well that advise on structures. And I think you've done a very good job of attracting speakers from a variety of different locations. So I note you have speakers from the British Virgin Islands, speakers from the Bahamas, speakers that originate from Trinidad, but are part of STEP Global, which is a very, very important organization. And then within the Chinese speakers, I think you have covered a wide range of expertise, whether it be capital markets, whether it be tax planning opportunities, or whether it be residency and lifestyle planning opportunities. I think that the coverage has been very good. So I'm very excited with the quality of speakers and the quality of attendees.
当然有收获，因为很多朋友可以在一起聊天，然后呢，关心的话题呢又全是与离岸金融有关的，那不同的行业的人有不同的视角，然后认识很多朋友，这个是我特别的。质量非常不错的你们的这个峰会，第一个呢就是我看过你们的这个嘉宾的 list。还是相当有质量，
对
因为很多呢是这我们这个论坛呢，其实我觉得，官员来的少，全是从业者多。那从业者多的情况下呢，大家讲的都是实打实的，现在用一个词很流行叫干货，讲的都是干货，不讲虚的那个政策形式啊，
对，
那就没必要了。这是一方面，第二个方面质量高呢，就是与会者，因为我刚才我讲完下来跟不少。朋友们交换名片，那我看了一下，大概留意了一下大家的这些职业，那我也觉得质量还是相当棒。从我个人来讲，我很有意愿参加。
我觉得办得非常成功，组织得非常好，因为我参加过很多这种峰会啊。那其实峰会的质量呢，最主要的是取决于组织者，所以我觉得 AOA 是非常有经验的，办得非常成功，而且这个时间控制的是绝对是非常非常准，所以这一点给我印象非常深刻。我觉得就是说，可能从一开始从你们的选题方面就比较能够抓住目前的这些行业里面的热点， 那么也是来的这个来宾以及听众所关心的一些话题，所以这样子就是说来宾讲的时候，虽然说可能有些来宾时间很短，20分钟，但是呢都能够抓住听众的这些注意力，所以从这一点来说呢，选题非常重要。然后呢，从你们选的这些人呢，也是都是行业里面相对比较有经验的，经验比较丰富的，所以讲的内容可能就是实践性比较强一点。那这个呢，就是说，就是可能就是说，对于听众来说是比较享受的一些，可以学到一些很多的内容。那因为选题好，讲的人也好，所以呢，在这个茶歇的时候呀，这个相互之间的交流就很活跃。所以我觉得这从这方面来说，质量是非常高的。而且从形式上来说，选的这个会场的这个也是非常一流的会场，然后呢时间上面控制的都非常好，配有同声翻译，所以我觉得非常成功。